And I would absolutely love to have that honor of wearing a dress like that. Hello guys, and welcome back to my channel. So we are here for a part two of last week's video. So these are going to be my quote unquote cost plans for 2020. So obviously none of these things are official, but they are things I would love to do in this new year, and hopefully they come to fruition. But if not, it's okay, because honestly they're not planned for anything. If they happen, they happen. If they don't, they don't. Whatever. Whatever works. So, as I said in my last video, I will be doing two cosplays from Star Wars this year. So, I don't want to reveal what either of them are for reasons, but I will say the second one that I have is from The Rise of Skywalker, and I had already planned the first one out. I had actually already bought most of, like, the supplies for it and all of that. I saw The Rise of Skywalker for the first time with my parents. There was a character that came on screen, and I remember I looked at my mom and I was like, darn it, now I want to make that one too. And so here we are. I went from just barely having one, like deciding that within like 2 weeks before, to basically saying, yep, now there's another one. So that's gonna be fun. Sorry, my hair is like everywhere today, so I'm probably gonna be fixing it throughout this video. So sorry. My next two, it's kind of a duo cosplay, but not really. So I wanted to do a cosplay from this fandom from a very long time because it was my original fandom. A lot of you probably don't know this, but I was a diehard Twilight fan. And when I say diehard, I mean like die hard. Like, I look back on that time and I'm like, how did I even have friends? Like, I was bad. And the nice thing is, like, I accept it now. I accept that's who I was in middle school and like slightly into high school. I will fully own that that was who I was. Am I proud of it? Not really, but like, I'm not gonna hide it. So come to find out, Katie, Meg, and I are all three were Twilight girls. So I decided that I wanted to do two cosplays from that fandom just to bring it back to where it all started. I was searching on Poshmark for another cosplay, but I found the perfect dress for it. So I will be doing in 2020, I will be doing Bella Swan as a newborn vampire. I will put a picture right here in the blue dress. I ordered some red contacts and I will be doing a review of those once I actually like get them out of the box and all of that. I will be doing another version of Bella, but I'm gonna keep that a secret for now because it will be part of my KatsuCon lineup. Another one that I really, really hope to do in 2020 is Scarlet Witch. I absolutely love Wanda. She was one of my first favorite Avengers. Black Widow has topped that now, but I loved Wanda. I loved her powers and I loved her character as well. If I had to choose, I would probably either do her Infinity War or Civil War outfits. I really, really like her corset in Civil War, but the Infinity War jacket I really, really like. And so it's gonna be a huge toss up. I really love both of those costumes, so it's gonna be a pretty hard pick for me which one to end up doing. To keep going with the superhero theme, I would also love to accomplish one of Black Widow's new suits from her solo movie, either the white one or the gray one. I absolutely love those suits. They look so cool, and I would love to wear one of them. I feel like a complete boss, because there's another word I want to say, but I can't say it because YouTube. So I feel like a total boss when I wear the suit that I have now, and I would love to continue that by getting a new suit and upgrading her. So we'll see if that happens. Last but not least for the superheroes, I would love to accomplish a Wonder Woman cosplay this year. I think that would be so much fun. This may just end up being like the year of superheroes, who knows? But I would absolutely love to either have her armor from her original solo movie or from Wonder Woman 1984. I also absolutely loved like the gold armor that was in the trailer for 1984. I guess it all depends on A, my budget, and B, like my skill. I would love to work more with foam or latex or anything that I could make the armor out of for that, because I would love to try and make it myself. Another plan I have for 2020 that may not come to fruition, but I'm crossing my fingers that it does, because it's a little crazy right now with my like lack of skill level, but I feel like this is one of those cosplays that if I could find it either like on Poshmark or in a thrift store, I could absolutely like make it into what I need and call it a day. That cosplay would be Mary Queen of Scots from CW's Reign. I absolutely love that show. As you guys know by now, I'm a history dork, and I know that show basically just turned it all into a teen drama. There's very few moments of that show that's actually historically accurate, but I loved it. And if I were to choose a dress that Mary wore that I could like potentially make with my skill level, I would want this one right here from season one. It was the Frost Festival. I believe it was the Frost Festival. It's been a while since I saw the show. But that dress with the red flower crown and the lace dress, I always thought it was really, really pretty, and it's simple. I can do that. I can manage that in some way, shape, or form instead of like a giant ball gown, which although I would absolutely love to have, it's not possible right now. So the last cosplay that I have, quote unquote, like planned for 2020. Now, because this would be like my biggest endeavor, because the other ones I can potentially buy, and I guess I could potentially buy this one too, but it's gonna be like a lot, with everything that would go into it. But I would absolutely love to be Queen Anna from the epilogue of Frozen 2. So that one, I don't want to buy it. I want to make it myself. I want to challenge myself to do that and have a product that I can wear and say that I did that. I made that from scratch. And Anna is my favorite Disney princess, and I will fully admit that when I saw Frozen 2 the first time and they announced her as Queen Anna of Arendelle, I will fully admit that I cried because it's not every day that you get to see your favorite, like strong-willed Disney princess get to move up and be a queen. And that was really, really powerful for me. And I'm sure for a lot of other people who enjoy Frozen and just like strong female empowerment in general. So I would love to have that dress. It's so beautiful. It means so much for myself personally and for Anna as a character. And I would absolutely love to have that honor of wearing a dress like that. All right, you guys, so that is it for this week's video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give it a big old thumbs up and leave a comment down below of some of your cosplays for 2020. I would love to hear what you guys are thinking, what you guys are planning, what you really want to do, even if it doesn't come to fruition. Like, I just want to hear from you. If you liked this face and want to see more of it, feel free to hit that subscription button down below so you can keep up to date on all of my videos, as well as follow my social media links down below in the description box. I have Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, like all of them are listed down there so you can go check them out and see what you'd like to do. So, hope you guys have a great day, have a great week, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!